It's Coco here for the Ministry of Sound Clubber's Guide, joined by arguably one of the best drum and bass DJs in the whole wide world, Andy C.
How you doing?
I'm good, you're
right. Good to see you. Yeah, I'm great. I've just turned up SW4. It's been a long weekend, but...
It's not over yet. You've still got two more days.
Yeah, well, you lot might have. No, I've just come... SW4 is like, you know, a highlight on the calendar for me, like being my hometown festival, and especially at the end of the summer that I've had, you know, it's beautiful to come here. Smash out D&B on the main stage.
On the main stage,
yeah,
as well.
Yeah.
What's your life set up now?
Me and three turntables and some headphones.
CDs, USB?
Tractor.
Yeah. Which is what I wanted to ask you about.
But using decks, yes.
Using decks. So, like I said, arguably one of the best DJs, drum and bass DJs. Take it.
Just so you say.
Wear it. Wear it proud.
I'll take it with pride, yes.
You obviously started when it was vinyl.
I did.
How was it switching format when you were like at the top of your game?
I thought it was going to be a lot more of a, you know, wow, what's he done, like, you know, and but I got pushed into it because I turned up at a festival in Denmark, Copenhagen. My records never turned up, and I had Tractkor on my computer, and I'd never ever played a set with it, not even at home. I just had it on the computer. And the guy's like, you know, this big festival, and the guy's like, how can we play? No records. And I'm like, we've got Tractkor. Anyone got a box? So he gave me a box, and then on the way to the show, I kind of put some tunes from my library into Tractkor, basically downloaded the driver backstage at the festival, went on stage, set it up, and it just worked.
That is, I use Tractkor, and it does not work.
I'm not joking. Well, this is it, right? So for years and years, I'd seen everybody struggling and trouble and this, that, and the other, and I'm thought, that's too much hassle. And you know what? It absolutely rolled out so well, I couldn't believe it, right?
Wow.
So the next day, I fly from there to Portugal. My record, my dub plates turn up, worst set ever. Skipping needles, terrible sound, and I was like, that's a sign. And then I went to Burning Man Festival in California the next week and basically played in a dust storm in the desert on Tractkor. And it, well, without that, it wouldn't have worked. So it was like, this is it now. And the beautiful thing is, what it affords me is the opportunity to take my entire record collection everywhere. And obviously, these all-night sets that I do, it facilitates that, basically. Because I used to do long sets and rock up with, like, crates and truckloads of records. And now I've got everything. And if I look at the crowd and I'm like, I see this part of the crowd here vibing on certain music and that crowd up there vibing, I know that I can easily select some tunes that are going to vibe them up, and like, we can just, you know, it's more of a party.
Wicked. Oh my goodness. Well, that was really good to hear from you. You've got to go on set.
I have. I've got to go and set up, and I'm going to have a great time, man. No doubt you've got
to
have a lovely day.
Yeah, man, I'm going to.
That'd be ironic, wouldn't it? It's going to go like a dream, I'll tell you. It's going to go like a dream.
Right. Lovely meeting you.
Thanks, Coco. Take care, darling.